Today we will study about types of centrifuges. In the last previous video we have seen the basic principle of centrifugation technique. Now we will see the types of centrifuge. All centrifuges can be roughly divided into four basic types on the basis of their operating speed. The first one is a small bench centrifuge. It is very simple and small and inexpensive also, and can be placed atop a desk as the ring. Small bench centrifuge, sometimes also known as desktop centrifuges. Okay, and usually this is used to collect rapidly sedimenting particles or substances such as RBCs, yeast cells, or bulky precipitate of chemical reaction. And also known as clinical centrifuges. Their maximum speed usually ranges between 3000 to 6000 RPM, and they do not have any temperature regulatory or system. That means it works on room temperature. And these centrifuges have maximum carrying capacity. Separation can be carried in 10, 50 or 100 cubic centimeter tubes. And in all these centrifuges, the rotors are mount on a rigid shaft. This is the simple diagram of desktop centrifuges. And this is the rotor and this is the shaft. And to this shaft, this rotor is attached and holes are here for the centrifuge tubes, and this is motor. Okay. Now, second one, centrifuges, large capacity refrigerated centrifuge. Their maximum speed is just like a small bench centrifuge, but it contains a refrigerated chamber which maintain the temperature. Okay. And one more difference point is their rotors are interchangeable. Their rotors may be interchangeable, that is swinging bucket and fixed angle rotors are present. And in this centrifuge, 10, 50 or 100 cubic centimeter capacity centrifuge tubes are used. In some centrifuges, their high capacity bottles are also used for centrifugation. That's why the name is large capacity refrigerated centrifugation, because the speed is the same, just like a small batch, but it is refrigerated and it can centrifuge a large volume. Now, this centrifuge is used to collect RBCs, nucleus or chloroplast. Then third one is high speed refrigerated centrifuge. This high speed refrigerated centrifuge works on high speed, and the speed of rotor is around 25,000 RPM, which produce about RCF, that is relative centrifugal force of 60,000 G. And again, in this interchangeable rotors are used, that is fixed angle and swinging bucket rotors are present, and these instruments are used to collect cellular debris or cell organelles, microorganisms and precipitate proteins through salting microorganisms and precipitated proteins through cell salting out process. Okay, and the last one is ultra centrifuge. As the name suggests, ultra centrifuge, it can operate with maximum speed of up to 25,000 RPM, providing 90,000 G centrifugal force. Okay, now at such a speed, the friction between air and the spinning rotor generates significant amount of heat. And to eliminate this source of heating, the rotor chamber is evacuated by two pumps. And apart from this, the ultra centrifuge has a refrigerating system which can maintain the temperature between 0 degrees Celsius and 4 degrees Celsius, so that they can maintain the heat. Okay, because many biological samples can denature or damage at high temperature. So it is very important when we handle with the biological samples to maintain the temperature. It should not raise above the 30 or 35 degree Celsius. Okay. Now the dry set on which, in the stop of ultra centrifuge, the dry set on which rotor is mounted is merely 1 by 16 inches in diameter, and the small diameter allows the shaft to flex during rotation. And the shaft is made up of aluminium or titanium alloy of high tensile strength to withstand the great force, because it is generated during centrifugation. At such high speed, a great centrifugal force is generated, and to withstand this force, the alloy which used in shaft formation is should be very strong. That is made up of, or it should be of high tensile strength, that is of made up of titanium or aluminium. Okay. Now this can be either carried out with a desire to obtain a certain biological material in solution or a purpose to characterize the biological material. And hence there are two types of this ultracentrifuge, that is protective ultracentrifuge to isolate the biological sample or any sample, and the second one is analytical ultracentrifugation, in which apart from isolation or separation we also characterize the particular sample.